Project Lead the Way building level training. We hope to give you an introduction to Project Lead the Way by providing some activities that are project and problem based that will give you an opportunity to see the program through the student's eyes today. But first, I'm going to provide you with a little bit of an overview on STEM education and Project Lead the Way. So here's a quick video to get started.
My magnifying glasses. Don't you see things that you need to see? It also gives you headaches. Hey, you know what I'm thinking? It makes the world more awesome. Because the world is full of problems. There's also lots of problem solvers. He's like, hey, he's 11 years old and he can get different tracking wheels for bikes. Sandbags, and all sorts of stuff. And this awesome little Brooke, when she was 12 years old, she created a video system to help owners stay connected to their dogs. What? Creating new stuff out of your brain can be hard, but I think I may have a next great invention. Every time that I try to clean the house, my cat goes crazy. The problem? He hates the vacuum cleaner. I want to solve this problem by making the first vacuum cleaner. To make this happen, you're going to need some help. Time to leave for big time in the middle.
Yeah, we'll stop that one right there in the interest of time today. So, Mrs. McCall already introduced all of us, so I'll skip that one. This next video is just an overview of Project Lead the Way and what their program hopes to do.
PLTW has invested resources in developing elementary curriculum so we can provide a K-12 continuum that really prepares even our youngest students for the global economy.
The elementary curriculum is just engaging for my students. Really, science has become their favorite subject. They so look forward to our time and when we're working on projects.
The students are highly engaged. They are very excited about their projects, anxious to explain to you what they're doing. They really don't want to stop working on that activity to move on to the next thing.
They find that when I introduce a project to them, or we have a project lead the way project, they get so excited about it. They go home afterwards, they want to look things up on the internet, do further research. They come back, they want to share with their classmates what they've learned, and it's just taking our learning to a whole new level.
The lesson that we did today is based on the Three Little Things. We've been reading the story and talking about the Three Little Things. So today, you all been given a different surprise. Their goal is to create a house that cannot be blown down by the big bad wolf.
I need a house out of the river and cross it. I'm learning from engineers and 3 years to never give up.
No one has the same supplies at the table, and I have to admit they do better than I did in my samples. All mine do. Lead the Way activities are very different from a traditional standpoint. The olden days were you do it this way, it's the only way, it's right or wrong. This curriculum opens it up to there is no right or wrong. If we make a mistake, it's not the end of the world. I don't want to be perfect, I'm not perfect. I understand that. Next time, I would try this way.
How could you change it for that? How could you change it to make it better? This is awesome. Like, think about it.
My hope, or hope for my students in the future, is really that they'll be inspired by the Project Lead the Way curriculum to become mathematicians and scientists. I tell them all the time that someday they're going to solve the world's biggest problems, and they're going to be creating innovations that will change the way the world operates. And I really think that this curriculum is the beginning step to inspiring them to do wonderful things.
We love Project Lead the Way as a whole. And looking at it at the elementary level, now what we're finding is that those students are able to. So in comparing the programs at the various levels, we already see it happening at the high school level tremendously. We're seeing it at the middle school level a little bit more. And now, for us, it's more looking into the future, saying, oh my gosh, look what we're going to see over the progression of all of these years for these kids, just exactly what we're hoping.
Project Lead the Way has programs for elementary, middle school, and high school students. The elementary program is called Launch. So anytime you hear Launch, that just refers to their elementary program. And that video was from a Launch classroom. So your classrooms will probably look much the same.
Do you want me to
turn
the lights off?
What is STEM? Science, technology, engineering, mathematics, education is an interdisciplinary approach to teaching and learning that yields greater complexity than is provided by the four disciplines in isolation. In addition, STEM education better reflects the challenges of the world around us. Effective STEM education has the potential to help students not only gain important STEM content, but also help students apply knowledge and skills to solve meaningful and socially relevant real-world problems. And video. This video I took off of the Billings Education Foundation website. They have a lot of helpful information on there as well. We're teaching STEM, but our tool is Project Lead the Way. But it's just one of the many tools, so it's not the only thing we're using. So you keep doing everything else we've been doing with technology and math and science, but the focus is to integrate more. STEM goals. Expand the number of students who ultimately pursue advanced degrees and careers in STEM fields, and broaden the participation of women and minorities in those fields. Expand the STEM-capable workforce and broaden the participation of women and minorities in that workforce. And increase STEM literacy for all students, including those who do not pursue STEM-related careers or additional study in the STEM Institute.